there is one more operator available, that is comma operator. Okay, actually comma operator is not only the operator, the comma also acts as a separator. Okay, now what is exactly that we have to see now. Actually, as a point of interview, it is very important. Okay, now see comma operator. This comma operator can be used as a separator as well as a operator. In this way, this comma can be used as a separator as well as operator. Now, how it is used as a separator? Suppose in any C language instruction, like I want to create variables, integer type 2 variables, then I can use this comma as a separator. How? See, suppose in this way, I want to create P as well as Q, two variables, then here this comma act as a separator. Getting? Now, what is comma operator that we have to see now? See, comma is again a binary operator. That means it acts on a two operands and it is having the least priority, least precedence. Okay, means normally we know that parenthesis is having highest precedence. After that, precedence means priority. Priority means in which order, if any expression is having multiple operators. Okay, then which operator will be evaluated first, which action will be taken plus, that is nothing but the priority or precedence of operators. This comma operator is having least precedence. Okay, least means it is having lowest priority. That's why, see how it acts first. See, suppose I have written like this, there is one integer variable a and I am assigning like this a equals to 5, 2 in this way. Okay, see, suppose I am writing like this a equals to 5, 2. Here I am writing two values here, 5 and 2. Now this here, this comma is acting as a operator, not a separator. Okay, now 5 and 2, these two are the operands. Comma operator, how it acts? This will resolve the first operand and will ignore it and again resolve the second operand, and then whatever value will be there, that will get returned. Suppose it is again having one more operand following it, then it will again ignore whatever the action now taken place and will resolve the third operand. In that way it will act. We see, for example, here comma operator. See, now I'm going to explain how this comma operator, comma is acting as a operator. In as a separator it acts like this. Now how this comma acts as a operator, that I'm going to explain now. Suppose I have declared one variable a here and I'm writing a equals to 5, 2. Here this comma is acting as a binary operator because on this side there is one operand, on this side there is second operand. That's why it is acting as a binary operator. Now how it acts? It will resolve the first operand, whatever left hand side operand, and will ignore whatever result. And then it will resolve the second operand, and then that whatever may be the result will get returned. That's why inside a means after execution of this, it will return 2. But see, here equal to is having higher priority, higher precedence than comma. That's why first equal to will get resolved and after that this action will get takes place. That's why here a equals to 5 first it will get resolved. That's why after execution of this statement you will get 5 inside a. But suppose you have placed bracket here like 5, 2 in this way. Here this parenthesis is having higher priority than this equal to. That's why first this will get resolved and then whatever may be the value returned by this operation will be assigned in B, in A, will get stored inside A. Now how C, again the same thing, comma operator, how it acts? It will act like, it will first resolve whatever left hand side operand phi, and it will ignore, discard it, and again will go here whatever right hand side of right hand side is here 2, it will return the value 2, and that will get stored inside this A. Means whatever result of this expression is 2, and then it will get stored inside A. That's why after execution of this statement, suppose you print whatever value of A, then you will get 2. Now suppose I have written like this, suppose A equals to 2, 5, 6, 8, in this way suppose the statement is. Here how that comma operator acts. First see, initially suppose we have not placed here any bracket, then initially 2 value will get stored inside A, okay, and this all part will get ignored, and finally you will get whatever, suppose you are displaying value of A, then you will get result as a 2. But suppose you have placed here brackets like 2, 5, 6, 8, now how it will act? See, first this will get resolved because of parenthesis. Parenthesis is having higher precedence than this equal to. That's why first this part will get resolved. How? And see, the comma operator is having again left to right associativity. Here we have used this same operator 3 times. Getting same operator 3 times. Whenever same priority operators are there multiple times in any expression, then which operator should get resolved first, which action should get taken place first, that will be decided by the associativity of that operator. Now here all operators are same, and here comma operator is having left to right associativity. That's why first left hand side will get resolved. Now here first this one will get resolved, and whatever may be the result, on then that result will be the first operand, and this 6 will be the next operand. In that way it will act. Now see, 2, 5 I have written here. Now first we know that it will take first operand, whatever, it will discard it and will take whatever value of second operand, 5 will be returned. Now here the result will be 5, then 6, 8. Now this action will get taken place. Now 5, 6 means what? Again it will discard the first operand and will take the second one, and that value will get returned. That's why it will return 6 and then 8. In this way it will act. Again 6 and 8, here again this will get discarded and 8 value will be taken and will get returned. That's why inside A you will get 8 after execution of this statement. Getting? In this way. Now this is nothing but the comma operator. Comma acts as a separator as well as operator in this way. Now we will see one example for this. See, this is a simple C program. Okay, here this hash include stdio.h. Here I have included the stdio.h header file because I am using here printf statement. Now void main, this is the main function of every C program, and I have declared here C 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C and X, 4 integer variables. And now the statement is like this, X is equals to this one. Okay, now see here, this equal to is having less priority than this parenthesis. Actually this comma is having less priority than this assignment operator, but here we have placed parenthesis. That's why always parenthesis will get resolved first, and after that whatever may be the next priority operand. Now see, here I have written A equals to 4, then comma B equals to 3, again comma C equals to 10, and comma X equals to A plus B plus C. In this way I have written. Now see, first comma, 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 all are the same precedence operators, because all are same operators. Okay, now whenever the precedence is same, then operators will get resolved as per associativity. Here all are having same same precedence, and associativity of that comma operator is from left to right. That's why here left to right execution will taken place. Now first this will gets executed. Now A, the value of 4 will gets assigned to A, and whatever then, but A will have value 4, but here A will have value 4, but this will not gets written. This will gets discarded, and whatever value of B, whatever it may be, it will gets written. B will have value 3, and the value 3 will gets returned. Okay, now after that, what is the result of this expression? That is nothing but 3. Now what will happen? Again, this 3 is the one operand, and this one is the next operand. In this way, these two operands will act now. Okay, the result of this first expression is a 3. Now 3 and C is equals to 10. Now this first operand will get discarded, and second operand will get resolved. Now C will have value 10 after execution of this statement, and the 10 value will be returned here. This 3 will be discarded. Why? Because always comma operator, how it works, suppose comma, we are operating A comma B. This is the action suppose. Then in this case, left hand side gets resolved, but whatever may be the result of that left hand side will be discarded, and again it will go for right hand side, and whatever may be the result will be returned. That will be the answer always. Means whatever value of B will be the answer always here. Okay, we will be the result of this operation. Now that's why here what will taken place here, C equals to 10 and B equals to this value is the first operand is 3 and second operand is C equals to 10. In this case, what will happen? First, C is equals to 10 will get resolved because equal to is having higher priority. That's why C will get assigned value 10 here, and then 3 and 10 in that comma operator will act. Getting C will have value 10, and after that this comma operator will get resolved. In that case, 3 and 10 in this, the right hand side will be returned. That's why 10 will be returned here, and 10 will be the one operand, and this one will be the second operand now for this comma operator. Now but first this equal to will get resolved first, because this one is having higher priority than this comma. That's why here x will become like a plus b plus c, means 4 plus 3 plus 10, that is 17 will get stored inside this x in this way. And now that 17 will be here, and 10 and 17 it will return whatever value, that is 17 here. Suppose there is one more variable y, I will put here y, and inside that y, what is the value, what will be the value inside that y? Again 17 will get stored. Now suppose we are displaying value of x, then we will get 17. Suppose we are displaying in the same way, suppose we are displaying value of a, we will get 4, value of b we will get 3, value of c we will get 10, and value of x we will get 17. In this way the values of these variables, and this is the example of this comma operator. Getting, comma operator is a binary operator. It will discard the left hand side operand and will return the value whatever that may be from that right hand side operand. And here if multiple commas are there, okay, the associativity is from left to right, and comma is having least precedence. Okay, least precedence, that is nothing, that is all about this comma operator. Okay.